Good morning, children. So let's learn a class 6 lesson, that is diversity in living thing and their classification. You know, according to the geographical conditions in India or at a different places on the earth are very different. Okay, means in area, in the hot and humid area, the temperature becomes very hot during the daytime. And humidity also, humidity means amount of water content in the atmosphere. In other areas like in Kerala and all that, throughout the rain occurs in that particular area. In some area like on the hill stations or the high mountains, the temperature becomes very low. So the geographical conditions are different on the earth. So we find that living thing exist in all diverse conditions. So everywhere we see all the living thing in different types, that is different types of varieties of plants occur, different varieties of animals are occur in different regions, all these in diverse conditions also. So when we live in a certain place, we adjust to the condition there. Hum jahan pe rehte hain wahin pe hum log apne according to nature, according to environmental condition, we adjust ourselves. That is known as the adaptation that we learn already. So various types of living things have survived because of their ability to adjust themselves to the conditions in their surroundings. So take an example, the camel. The camel is well adapted or well adjusted according to the desert area. Okay, so it has a body adaptations to adjust its body in particular type of environment. Jaise ki fish hai. Fish is also adjustable to live in a water, means fish has gills, it is absent of lungs. So with the help of that gills, it can breathe. Okay. So that means the diversity of plants. We have to learn diversity of plants. So diversity means according to geographical condition, according to different places, according to and different environmental conditions, the plants are found in that particular area. That means diversity in plants. So various types of plants are found in many places around us. Some plants like grass are short, some wild, others are tall and have a canopy. Some plants grow underwater, while some other float on water, means free-floating plants. Some are the submerged plants. We find that some plants grow even in desert area. Moreover, we find that there is a lot of variety of same types of plants. For example, there are different various of varieties of rice and wheat, different types of roses we say, different color of roses we say, different types of mangoes and different its flavor also. So some plants grow even without stem, without leaf or roots. So these are very different from ordinary plants. So let us learn diversity among the plants. Okay, so see, plants, you know, the plants are autotrophs. So plant shows autotrophic mode of nutrition. Why? Because plants are able to prepare their own food by the process of photosynthesis in the presence of sunlight, water, mineral and carbon dioxide. The plant produces its own food in the form of glucose, and that oxygen that releases outside in the atmosphere through the stomata, that is the photosynthesis process. So like all the green plants like hibiscus, pomegranate, periwinkle, and some plants, they are green plants, they are shows the autotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, some plants like fungus, that is dodder plant, it is parasitic plant, other saprophytic plant, So they are not prepare their own food because they lack the food that plants that depend on the other plants for their food, that is heterotrophic plants. Okay, plants like the pitcher plant, even they consume the insect. So these are called the insectivorous plants. So there is a diversity in each plant. Okay, so let's learn about the plants today. Now in the basic structure of plant. The plant structure can generally be divided into two parts. Okay, the root system and the shoot system. See? A basic structure of plant is divided into root system. The roots are that go deep into the soil. The portion which grows into the soil, that is roots. That is called the root system. The roots absorb the water from the soil. It also anchors the plant. Okay, it supports the various nutrients, minerals to the plant. And the plant, the part which go above the soil, that is the shoot. Okay, the shoot carries various branches. Okay, on the branches, it has leaves. That is called the stem. Okay, then flowers come out here. After flower matures, that converted into fruits. Then fruits are carried inside seeds. So it is a basic structure of plant. So like now, label this plant, root, leaf, leaves. This is the stem. Flowers and it is fruit. This is fruit. Okay, children. So it is a complete structure of a plant. Now, one by one, we see the roots. Roots hold the soil firmly and anchor the plant. The main functions of root are to absorb the and transport water and nutrients from the soil. The roots of a carrot and radish also store the food. There are two different types of root, that is taproot and fibrous root. So two different types of roots are present, that is taproot and fibrous root. Okay, then the next two root is the stem. Stem, the height, shape and size of a plant depends upon the stem. The stem carries out the functions of production, conduction and storage of food. In some plant, it has the functions of reproduction. It gives support to other parts of the plant. It is a basic function of stem. Okay, then the leaf. The leaf is a flat. It plays an important role in the production of food. Leaves are mainly of two types. There are the two types of leaves, that is simple leaf and compound leaves. Okay, so simple leaves and compound leaves. Then flowers. This is the most attractive part of the plant. It is also reproductive part of the plant. It is connected to the stem by a stalk which may long or a short. A flower has a typical color and shape also. A flower is important by means of reproduction. So after flower, you will get the fruit. The fertilization takes place and we will get a fruit. So fruit have different shape. You know the lots of fruit we eat. They are very tasty, delicious. Some are sour fruit, some are sweet in taste. So fruits contain one or more seeds also. The pods of beans and peas are actually fruits. It is a basic structure of plant, and there are different parts of the plant. Roots, stem, leaves, flowers, fruits and seeds. These are the different parts of a plant. Now, there are also different two types of roots also. There are the different types of leaves also. Simple leaf and compound leaf. Okay. Hibiscus, mango, leaf is are the simple leaf, whereas the rose, neem, babool, these leaves are compound leaves. Then why there is need for classification? Our topic is we are diversity in living thing, in diversity in plants. So there are varieties of plants occur on the earth. So they have different diversity. So why there is need for classification? Kyun zarurat padi classification? Because we know, we have information about lakhs of plants. Okay, lakhs of plants which are available on the earth, and plants has been collected. While studying the diversity in plants, they are classified for the sake of convenience on the basis of similarities and differences in their structure. It is an easy way to study the plants. When you classify the plants in different categories, by the classification according to its leaves, type of leaves, we can categorize. According to types of roots, we can categorize the plant. According to its thickness of the stem, or flowering plants, non-flowering plants. So it is a convenience. For the convenience, for the sake of the convenience, on the basis of the similarities and differences in their structure, their organs and other characteristics too. So the scientists that categorize plant in various types, such as some plants are comes in a herb area, some plants come in a shrub area, some plants comes in a flowering plants, non-flowering plants, so that it is easy way to study the plant because of its classification. Now let's see the classification of plants. We can easily notice the differences in the shape and height of the plant in our surrounding. It is easy to classify the plant on the basis of this observation. Okay, कि जैसे हम लोग देखते हैं कि हमारे सराउंडिंग में कितने सारे वराइटीज ऑफ प्लांट्स है. कुछ प्लांट छोटे हैं, कुछ बड़े हैं, कुछ बहुत ही छोटे हैं. हम लोग उसको देख भी नहीं पाते, अच्छे से उनका स्टडी भी नहीं कर सकते, उनके पार्ट्स भी नहीं देख पाते. और कुछ प्लांट्स इतने बड़े हैं, बहुत सारे बड़े बड़े ट्रीज है. सो देयर इज नीड फॉर क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ प्लांट. Trees means some plants grow tall. Their stem or the trunk is hard and strong. They have branches at some height above the ground. They bear flowers and fruits also for many years. Such a plants that are called the trees, like neem tree, banyan tree, mango tree. So the trees are tall, big and perennial, and they live for many years. Okay, like mango, banyan. So these are the trees. Because tree bola to kaise unke tree matlab hamare aankhon ke samne kya aata hai, uska bada sa stem hoga, bada sa trunk hoga, uske upar brown color ki बार्क होगी, बड़े बड़े उसके जो लीव्स जहां से आते तो कुछ डिस्टेंस से ऊपर तक आते हैं, ट्रीज मतलब नीम ट्री, मैंगो ट्री. सो ऑल दिस वन टाइप ऑफ प्लांट, जैसे जैसे दिखते हैं वो बड़े बड़े ट्री, जैसे वो सब ट्रीज के इसमें डाल देंगे, लाइक मैंगो, नीम, जामुन, बनाना. ओके, सो दैट देन वॉट आर देन श्रब्स. श्रब्स मीन्स सम प्लांट्स ग्रो क्लोज टू द ग्राउंड. जो श्रब्स होते, जो कुछ प्लांट्स होते वो थोड़े छोटे होते साइज से. They close to the ground. They give out branches very close to the ground. जैसे कि आपने देखा होगा pomegranate tree, that is comes in a shrub. Then rose is a comes in a shrub. They are shorter and smaller than the trees, but they have a thick and hard stem. Dolander, hibiscus, lantana, coranti, and rose are shrub. They may grow up to the 2 to 3 meters. Okay. So what are the similarities between shrubs and herbs? So shrubs are smaller than tree but bigger than herb. Trees सबसे tall होते हैं. और trees और shrub में क्या difference है? Trees are long trees. Their height is very much long. If they are taller than the shrub. Now the difference between shrub and herb. So herbs grow 1 to 1.5 meters tall. उससे भी small होते हैं herbs. और their stem of herbs are green and quite flexible and it's very delicate compared to those of trees and shrubs. Herbs may live for a few months or up to 2 years, but trees live for many years. Shrubs also can live many years, but these herbs can live only 1 to 2 months or 1 to 2 years. And their height is 1 to 1.5 meter tall. Okay, so it's a basic difference between trees, shrubs, and herbs. Herbs may hote hai tulsi herb hai. Then mint is in herbs, so they have a small fragrance also in herbs. Okay, then vines. You know, some vines need vertical support. The vines means the climbers, creepers, so they need the support. Some plants need support. They cannot stand erect because its stem is very weak. So they need support for growing, while some others spread on the ground. Climbers like the money plant have aerial roots. Have you seen the cucumber plant? They also required a support. Then that is the grapes tree. They also need a support because they have tendri. With the help of that tendri, that look like a spring-like structure, and they take the support of another plant or another thing. So the stem of a creeper is very flexible, soft and green. It grows rapidly with the help of a support. That means that are vines. So the life cycle of plants like jawar, sunflower is completed 1 year. So there are the some annual plants and some biennial perennial plants. So let's hear. We classify the plants according to its size, shape, according to its woody stem. Okay, like trees, shrubs, and herbs and vines. Okay, children. So this is about the classification of plants. In our next video, we learn about the few more points of classification of plants. Okay. So bye everyone.